Spaghetti code is easily avoidable once you know how to avoid it. First, though, let's talk about the problem. Things get really messy when you connect things together. And an application is ultimately all about connecting pieces of code to each other. But if you connect all the pieces to all the other pieces, suddenly you can't move anything around anymore. Now, you may have noticed that I'm not at my desk. I don't have my computer. Everything's white. It's actually a little weird. That's because we're in concept land. And the whole point of concept land is to not think about code. So, sit back, relax, and let's just talk in concepts and metaphors for a moment. Here's a metaphor. Let's go back in time to the invention of the telephone. See, when there were only two telephones, things were pretty simple. The phones could connect directly to each other, and then we're done. Two telephones means one connection. Now let's add another. Now we have three phones, and each phone still needs to connect to every other phone. That means three connections. Let's add another one. Now we have four phones, and each phone still needs to connect to every other phone. That's four phones and six connections. Now this is a pretty shape here, but it's not very good if you have a bunch of wires all over the place. Let's add several more. With 10 phones, we have a lot more connections. 45 connections, in fact. I'll tell you, this took me a while to draw. So you can imagine what 11 phones, or 15 phones, or 20 phones, or 2,000 phones would be like. So here's a table of what we've learned so far. As it turns out, the number of connections is ultimately defined by the equation n times n minus 1 all over 2, where n is the number of phones. Now, if you're a math geek, this is related to n times n plus 1 over 2. But in this case, n is 1 less than the number of phones. So I've simplified to this equation here. So now that we know that, how many connections would a small town with a population of 2,000 have? That would be 1,999,000 connections. I'm not going to draw this one for you. So how do we build this in reality? I'm sure you probably have a better solution in your head already. Let's make every phone connect to a hub. Now how many connections do we need? Well, if you think about it, for every phone you have, it connects to one thing, rather than n number of things. Let's take a look at our chart again. If we have two phones, our number of connections will be two. If we have three phones, our number of connections will be three. Four phones will be four, 10 will be 10, and 2,000 will be 2,000. As you can see, with two and with three phones, we end up actually doing better off or the same with our original direct connection method. But generally speaking, this shows you that connections are complexity. If you saw these two things on a graph, this one would go kind of like that. This one would linearly increase. So now we know that we should minimize our connections. It turns out software development is very similar. So let's take a look at that.